إِلَّا مَن تَوَلَّى وَكَفَرَ فَيُعَذِّبُهُ اللَّهُ الْعَذَابَ الْأَكْبَرَ إِنَّ إِلَيْنَا إِيَابَهُمْ ثُمَّ إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا حِسَابَهُمْ. الله أكبر.
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 سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. 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 الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ به ونتوكل عليه. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. الحمد لله. This is one of the days where the entire ummah celebrate. But oftentimes we forget what we celebrating. And I would like to remind myself first and everyone else that this is the day where we're celebrating La ilaha illallah. This is the day of La ilaha illallah. This is the day of Ibrahim alayhi salam with the sacrifice he was doing for La ilaha illallah. Where he gave the most sacred to himself, the most, the closest, the dear and near to himself, Ismail, for La ilaha illallah. We are, what we're doing today, we're celebrating La ilaha illallah. And this La ilaha illallah, Nabi sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam came with. هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم. He is the one who sent in the Ummiyin, the people of Mecca, a messenger from amongst them. يتلو عليهم آياته. ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا في قبل لفي ضلال مبين. Teach them the book, teaching them wisdom and elevation in their spirituality, tazkiyah, elevation in their akhlaq, elevation in their nafs, elevation in their morality, elevation in their sayings, elevation in their deeds. وَإِنْ كَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. Though before he came, يعني before النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وسلم came with this message, they were indeed lost. They were indeed misguided. في ضلال مبين. What did النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم do? he went to As-Safa. You know where As-Safa? Those of you who did Hajj before or Umrah, and those of you who didn't or did, may Allah give you the opportunity to do it again. As-Safa is a little bit elevation, little hill, really is what it was, still is relatively speaking. He went, An-Nabi al-A'zam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to As-Safa, and he called the people of Quraysh. He called the tribes. He called Al-Butun wal-Ashair and the people and all everybody from Mecca. When they all came, he said to them one thing, قُولُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ تُفْلِحُوا. Say, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, and you will succeed. This is about لا إله إلا الله. That we understand that there is no ma'bud but Allah. No one that we worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That no marghub, no one that you desire but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No matloob, no one that you want but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what la ilaha illallah means. That no one that you seek but la ilaha illallah. And this is the message of the prophets. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. Every messenger that came before you, ya Rasulullah, Allah Jalla Jalaluhu is telling him the meaning, but came with this message, لا إله إلا أنا, no, there's no God but me, so worship me. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the prophets alayhi wasalam, and that's what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, as the seed and final of the prophets, came to beautify and deliver. So we can carry this message. But when you also hear لا إله إلا الله, it means also that your heart has the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That you also, this day should also be a reminder not to do injustice against others, against yourself, against your neighbor, against your friend, against your family. Zulm, al-zulmu zulumat. And those people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes them, innahum kanu إِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. They are described in the Quran, when they were reminded by لا إله إلا الله, they become arrogant. They do injustices to people, and لا إله إلا الله does not stop them. That's not the morality of the Muslim. That's not the khuluq of the Muslim. That's not this what this Eid is all about. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر, وأشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم خاتم الأنبياء المعتبر, صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وعلى أصحابه وعلى أتباعه وذرياته وأزواجه إلى يوم الدين. This Eid also is the opportunity for many things that we should remember. Number one, Al-Udhiyah. Al-Udhiyah is a sacrifice. The Sunnah is that the first thing you do after the Salah is Al-Udhiyah. Those of you who can, the Sunnah is that the first thing you do after Salah is Al-Udhiyah. And the Udhiyah, you do it on three. Very simple. Look at the Sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu